like everything about you. Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. Welcome to the Keep Productive YouTube channel, if you're brand new, but if you're a regular, welcome back. So in today's video, I wanted to chat about another suite of applications called Moleskine. And many people may be like, Moleskine, they're the note takers. And of course they are. What I want to do today is dive into the new apps they're launching, what future is coming to these apps, and also a little bit about what I think about the sort of digital slash note-taking experience and how you can sort of, I guess, how companies are on the edge of that and sort of working through that. So to start off this story, I am of course a fan of notebooks and do follow a lot of channels on YouTube that cover notebooks. I have notebooks myself, I have some lovely Baron Fig ones, but Moleskine is clearly a company that's been around for a while now. Moleskine have always been, when I've gone to Italy, always been a book that has been available, a notebook that's been available to buy. And also in the UK, in a lot of the popular stores that I visit, like Waterstones, have Moleskines available, and they are super attractive leather-bound books. Now, after doing a little bit of research into Moleskine, and when I talk about research, I mean just going on Wikipedia and searching, Moleskine aren't that old as a company. I thought they were a lot older. I thought they were like 50, 60 years old, but they actually were created in 1997, which I feel is a lot younger than I thought it was. So Moleskine obviously have been creating notebooks for a fair while, and to some extent they've been on the sort of pinnacle of digital experiences in the last 5 to 10 years. Now I remember the first time that I captured this experience when I was using a lot of Evernote products. Evernote released something called the Evernote Moleskine Notebook, which allowed you to use these smart stickers and even use scanning functions on Evernote to sort of bring that to life. And that was really wicked because you could sort of get this note-taking experience or design experience that you had for years and sort of combined it with a new resource like Evernote. Well, it wasn't so new at the time. Evernote was out for a while, but it was such a nice sort of intersect. Now, of course, physical products have to develop. That's something that always sort of is prevalent in most spaces now. Most of the products have now become digital because they've almost forced themselves to with the changing markets. Moleskine are a company that have done this. In the last 2 or 3 years, they've released two iOS applications. Actually, they've released more than that, but I'm going to sort of dive into that in a second. They released two applications called Actions and also Timepage, which is a calendar application. Now, both of these applications are designed to give you a task management experience with Actions and a beautiful calendar experience with Timepage. Now, they are both exclusively on iOS, but they do work really, really well, and they're designed to a high-grade standard. Now, there is a subscription service inside this, so it's not a free app and totally. Obviously, that's how they're going to make money, but this is sort of a new era for Moleskine. Now, Moleskine are not newbies to creating applications. They actually created a few other applications in the past covering journal, note takers, and that sort of planner experience, but they didn't really hit the nail on the head with these. Now, when they released these, many of the other applications sort of jumped in and sort of became more predominant. So this sort of hit back with Actions and Timepage is almost like a new revelation, I don't know, in this sort of space. Now with Actions and Timepage, of course you have this really gorgeous looking experience, but there is one element missing, and that is notes. Moleskine, the note taker, has a note taking application. It's just not all that good. And this will be the next part of the puzzle for Moleskine. Of course, Moleskine have a great Actions application and Timepage application, but they really need a great Notes application. So I think in the next year we'll see this addition, and Moleskine will then have what they call a core suite. These three major productivity applications, the Note Taker, the Task Manager, and the Calendar experience that you necessarily need for personal productivity. So, of course, Moleskine have been at the forefront of trying to do this, but it's not actually the first company that's trying to do this. The company that I use with my notebooks, Baron Fig, actually developed their own apps, and they're also very progressive thinking in terms of being able to set up a podcast and lots more elements like that. Now, the difference is, to some extent, that Moleskine have gone for an agency with this, and it's not necessarily done in-house, but that's because they've become so big, to some extent, they're about 20 years old now, that they needed to become like developers and hire those professionals to be able to deliver these high quality applications. Now, of course, I think the future is definitely something like this, being able to have that sort of digital note-taking experience. So for example, let's say I bought a Moleskine notebook tomorrow. It's not necessarily me connecting it with my phone, but I would like to know that there's a note-taking application out there for Moleskine that would allow me to replicate a similar experience that isn't necessarily dull looking. The design of the applications needs to be on the standards of the great leather-bound books. And that's exactly what they're working towards now. So guys, hopefully that gave you a nice overview of how Moleskine is sort of progressing with their applications. I'm maybe a bit nerdy talking about this. I really like the topic of even subscriptions, even like app sort of processes, even like the digital and the physical side of stuff and how that's working out. So of course, let me know in the comments whether you would like to hear more of these sorts of conversations. But it was great talking about this. I really like to sort of dive into a topic like this. Anyway guys, hopefully you enjoyed this topic today. Let me know in the comments below what you thought. If you're not subscribed yet, hit that subscription button. And also check out the Moleskine applications below because I'll include links to all of them so far in the description below. And the references as well that are used too. Anyway guys, thank you so much for stopping by. Make sure to have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers. About you.